Malcolm's definitely a special player. He's one of those guys that can just change the game by himself. We talk about he's probably a fan favorite solely for the fact that he can bring you out of your seat in many different ways. He can go end-to-end or lay a big hit, do simple things, and you know what? Just because he's a pure athlete out there, he's a very talented player.
We were supposed to be picked up by my dad. And the rink was 30 minutes from the karate place, but the karate place was a mile from home. So he went to pick up my brother and forgot me a mile away from home, and family started dinner and everything. So I was a little crushed, so I just switched to hockey so I wouldn't get left a mile away from home.
What?
Yeah, it's pretty bad story. Yeah. During the summer, ran into a guy named Garrett Noonan, played here last year. And he lived near this place I was playing, this summer league I was playing in, and we got to talking, and he helped network and some other people also. So that's how I heard about it, and here I am. Really supportive. It was kind of strange. When we started up, the Panthers moved down there, and it was early when they moved down there. It was like every other kid was playing, but it died down because they didn't have any peewees or abandons programs set up or rinks. So it was, I guess my parents are still with those times, and they're really supportive. So it's been good for me, I guess.
Off the top, why do you wear number 2?
Just a D number, and I'm not a huge guy. 22 wouldn't fit on my jersey, so thought go with number 2.
Favorite hockey player and why?
Ed Jovanovski, who's with the Coyotes now, but in like 96 he was with the Panthers, and actually was one of the kids who got to go in the locker room, and he gave me a hockey stick, so it stuck in the back of my mind. But hey, it's a pretty cool guy.
That's all it takes sometimes. Your profile says you might want to start a business. What kind of business are we talking about?
Maybe consulting, maybe something in management. I feel like there's always a need for people to be consulted in management. I know that sounds vague, but
hey,
that's what consulting is.
It's usually, a six-figure job for sure. Dolphins, Jaguars, or Buccaneers?
Jaguars.
Favorite thing to do in Miami?
I like to go to the beach when I can, but I'm usually training, so it would be going to the beach.
Best part about playing hockey in Canada?
People care. It's a lot more important up here than it is in Florida. So,
who are you cheering for the World Juniors?
I told some of the guys that I was actually born in the Czech Republic when they scored, so I'm going to go by Czech.
You're a free agent then. Last good book or magazine that you've read?
Jet Magazine.
Okay. What courses were you taking in Boston College, and which one was your favorite?
I was a human development major, and there was a sociology class we took in like 40 people, but instead of making it rows, he set it up like a circle, and it was open discussion, so it's kind of fun how the students ran the class, so I kind of liked that.
Sounds interesting. Now, what do you miss from home?
My mom's cooking.
Got it. Put mom in there. The Panthers or the Lightning?
The Panthers.
What do you think of the Lightning?
I mean, they're okay, but they're up there by Disney World, so.
Surfing or tobogganing?
Tobogganing. Never been surfing.
You've never surfed?
Never surfed.
Oh, man. Well, tobogganing is fun. A big hit or a big goal?
Big goal. I wish I could get a lot more big goals because it doesn't seem like hits are too hard for me. So
yeah, you're no problem in the hitting department. Favorite food is?
Grits. It's made out of corn meal. It's not many people know what it is. It's, I guess, food for the poor people.
Okay. Who's the nicest guy on the team?
Probably me, honestly. Actually, no, Bryce. Bryce is the nicest guy on the team.
Are you serious?
No.
And you are?
I'm Malcolm Lyles, number 2, Vernon Vipers.